Hi everyone, this is Mondays with Michelle on Out Late But Great. And before I even get started on this week's topic today, I wanted to give a humongous thank you to the beautiful people over at Depp Fox for that unbelievably generous video they did mentioning this new channel. And I just want to tell everybody to please go over to Depp Fox's channel and check them out. If you're someone who has subscribed here that did not see that, they did a video mentioning our channel, and I woke up the next morning and there were about 48 new notices in my inbox of subscribers that had come to check it out here. And so for everybody that has signed on here in the last few days, anybody actually that has signed on at all, I wanted to thank you so very much, because we're really hoping that this channel will help people, and that was the whole purpose. And also to help us continue to deal with things that we're dealing with later in life. The topic this week was inspired by a note that we received here in our inbox from a gentleman from Saudi Arabia who is having a very difficult time just being himself, a gay person, in such a tremendously pressured cultural and religious environment. Now, while neither Jimson nor I know what it's like to live under the extreme pressures of the Middle East, it did manage to spur us into a topic that we could relate to and talk about. And so I thought it would be great if we talked about the cultural or geographical issues that we either face right now, have faced, or fear facing in our coming out process where we live. And so I am from the South, from Florida, and even though I don't live in an extremely ultra-conservative city in Florida, it still very much has the feel of the South. And I grew up here, and so, of course, this area has changed quite a bit since I was a little kid. But it certainly is different here than it would be, say, if I was living in San Francisco, New York, or L.A. One thing is for sure, it is conservative enough here that my partner and I don't dare walk around holding hands. And something that was really cool that happened last week is we went up to St. Pete Pride, and we were able to hold hands and kiss in public and not be worried about it because it was such a safe environment. But we certainly wouldn't do that on a regular basis here. And the closest we come to that is walking arm in arm. And so we have to be kind of stealth here. You know, I would still fear walking around and getting harassed, or, I don't know, just drawing too much attention to myself. You know, and so that being in St. Pete at Pride was a really wonderful thing. But if we were living, say, in New York, L.A., or San Francisco, I certainly would be more, let's say, extroverted with my affection towards her. And I'm not talking about anything really hairy or anything, you know, but just holding hands would be nice. And so it's something that I think people don't realize what we as gay people miss by not being able to express ourselves in that way. And so I want to dive back into the area of the Middle East, just because I want the person who inspired this topic to be more addressed in my video. I looked up some things that might be helpful. Down underneath where our information is, I put a bunch of links that I could find. One of them was gaymiddleeast.com. Another one was Global Gaze, and that, as you can see here, is gayz.com. And also there are organizations like hrc.org. Here in Florida, we have Equality Florida, which is eqfl.org. But it certainly doesn't seem that over in the Middle East they have any kind of support, really, for people who are coming out or are trying to live anything other than heterosexually. And so my heart really is breaking for this person who is going through these major struggles. And there was this other book that I could not find anywhere, but it was called Gay Travels in the Muslim World by an author named Michael, and the last name is Luongo. Again, I'll put that underneath. But the book looked fantastically interesting. Unfortunately, Barnes & Noble did not carry it, and they did have it online, but it seemed to be very expensive, and I'm not sure why that was. But there is another book that you might be able to check out. I don't know if you guys can find that over there. 2 years ago, my partner and I went to a gay film festival up in Tampa, and we saw this movie called A Jihad for Love, and it really put everything in perspective for me living in Florida, because I could gripe and complain about how not free that we have it here in this state, but all you have to do is see a movie like that and know what these people that were just determined to live authentically went through. I mean, we're talking execution, stoning, imprisonment. It's really, really bad. And I feel for that person who wrote to us, because I honestly can't imagine the pain that you would have trying to decide whether you wanted to take the chance on being found out or trying to just put what you know you are away inside and try to live like everybody else lives. I tried that for 20 years, you know, and that did not work, but it wasn't because my culture or my geographical surroundings would not let me. So I don't know if that helps you at all, but I put the links down below, like I said, and I just encourage you to, as stealthily as you can, try to find others in your area to support you. And I know, I can imagine that it must be just completely discouraging to feel like there's no one else near you that feels the same way. And for me, I would think that if I had the means, I probably would have to move, you know, but not everybody can do that. And just, it really just helps me put things in perspective. So to that person who wrote us, I really appreciated your honesty, and I've been thinking about you a lot ever since you wrote that to us. Okay, take care, everybody, and until next time.